Onto our lead story now, a debate ensued in Parliament today as to whether parliamentarian Ranjan Ramanayake did in fact table in Parliament the recordings of the telephone conversations.
Last evening, former Minister Ranjan Ramanayake made a statement in Parliament while mentioning several names, including mine. During that speech, he said he would table all the recordings of the telephone conversations in Parliament. I would like to know if you have already tabled it in Parliament.
I am currently in remand custody. All the CDs are in a locker at a certain bank. I have no way of travelling outside. However, I will table several telephone recordings, the ones that the government did not publish because it is detrimental towards them. I will hand it over before 6 p.m. I will also extend my fullest support to any commission. I have all these call recordings in my possession. Even now, this government is using my telephone conversations. I have sent some to Singapore because there was not enough space to create a backup.
Honourable Deputy Speaker, I would like to request you to provide him with special permission to travel to the bank and to obtain the CDs containing the telephone recordings.
My name had been mentioned yesterday when I was not present. I do not have any allegation or investigation against me, locally or internationally. I would like to request all those who make such statements to present facts to back up their statements. Do not entangle me in this. Do not sling mud at me through the use of Parliament.
In light of Ranjan Ramanayake's speech last evening, a false notion has been created that all 225 in Parliament are corrupt. However, I would like to say that this very clearly. I am glad I do not belong to the 75 who have sand permits. I am also glad not to be part of the 100 who own bar permits. Neither do I belong to the category which imports ethanol. Further, I am proud not to be someone who deals drugs or owns a betting center. People do not need to search for alternatives. There are exemplary characters within the Parliament. Ranjan Ramanayake should be able to prove what he said as well. If he tries to release himself from this issue while making others the wrongdoers, we cannot agree to that. In a way, we are glad he brought up such an argument, because it allowed people like me to show the people that we have not been involved in wrongdoing.
State Minister Mahindananda Aluthgamage expressed the following views about the phone recordings of parliamentarian Ranjan Ramanayake at a media briefing held in Colombo. While investigating the CDs, the police have identified this to be an organized conspiracy against the state. Furthermore, police have now identified that a group of MPs, including former Prime Minister Ranil Wickremesinghe, are connected to this. All this information justifies that Ranjan Ramanayake was a contractor who worked under the previous regime. See how big of a fraudster Ranjan Ramanayake is. I just called the General Secretary and the Sergeant at Arms in Parliament. Not a single CD has been submitted to Parliament before the session ended at 6:30 last evening. We challenge Ranjan Ramanayake to release any phone conversations recorded with the former President, former Minister, ministers, their wives and their children pertaining to the matter of hindering judicial process, as he mentioned, or else release the ones relating to the deals made with the previous government. Yesterday he asked to appoint a presidential commission to probe this, but why should the president appoint a commission? Cases have been filed against Ranjan Ramanayake. He can hand these CDs over to court once the case is taken up. All the dirty details of this deceptive actor have now surfaced. He confessed and tried to table some phone conversations made with members of the government, but he was not given the opportunity to release a single recording. Then he said MPs of the ruling party have talked over the phone. He said that Minister Kehelia Rambukwella had called me and I have called Kehelia Rambukwella. I spoke to a former minister of the UNP last morning over the phone. That was not for a personal matter. She asked me to handle the transfer of a police officer she knows. Meanwhile, UNP MPs expressed their views on the phone recording at the opposition leader's office in Colombo. There is no need to make Ranjan Ramanayake a hero at this point. He is not suitable to pose as a hero after what he did. Ranjan Ramanayake asked to appoint a commission to look into this and reveal the truth. Then we have to remind the people again how this government attempts to sell Ranjan's incident leading up to the general election. They did the same after the Easter Sunday attacks. Please solve this issue immediately.
ඉදිරිමැතිවරණයටත් රංජන් රාමනායක හඬපටියෙන් දුවන්න හදන මේ ආණ්ඩුව පුළුවන් තරම් ඉක්මනින් මේ ප්‍රශ්නේ විසඳන්න.
ඊයේ රංජන් රාමනායක රත්නමගේ කතා වෙලාවේ
It was a person from Nigambo who yelled the most and disturbed Ranjan Ramanayake while he was speaking. During the time when President was the Secretary of Defense, who visited this person when his house was raided, brother of the former Defense Secretary, the former President. My question is, within this policy, is the combination of the President and Prime Minister a healthy one? They can be brothers, but are they compatible? News First has highlighted time and time again the several hardships faced by the people of the country. The ever-increasing price of goods, the debt burden which has weighed down the people regardless of the concessions which were introduced recently, and the unending difficulties faced by local farmers are but an iota of the difficulties the citizenry in our country face. Against such a backdrop, it should be noted that 5 forensic audit reports of the central bank bond scam, which squandered millions in public funds, have been tabled in Parliament as of now. Further, our country is burdened with a debt repayment which exceeds $4 billion, which should be settled this year alone. The invisible threats from the international community, which could arise from our country being economically destitute, is another situation we should be aware and wary of. Amidst all of these hardships, threats and challenges, the legislature of our country seems to be preoccupied, debating over leaked phone calls. Is this not a mere waste of the invaluable money and time of the people? News First would like to reiterate what we reported on the 9th of this month, where we suggested that the matter of leaked phone calls is handed over to the proper investigative authorities, while Parliament focuses on resolving the immediate challenges the people face and also preparing us to face challenges of the future.